Good morning, everyone. This is 2B8-7, and to those who are keeping the Sabbath, I hope that you're having a blessed and happy Sabbath. Now, today I'm going to do a study later, but I wanted to start off with a testimony to give an illustration of how the Father works for us, sometimes using His messengers. And we all really need to pay attention to when the set-apart Spirit is at work, and that it's not us doing anything. But anyway, here goes. This particular night, I worked all night. I was working night shift at the time. I got off that morning, and which was typical sometimes. I stayed up all day ripping and running, doing errands, getting things organized, or what have you. But this particular reason was because I had to leave that evening to go on a temporary duty assignment. I was in the Air Force at the time, so I had to get everything organized. So I stayed up all day doing all these things, and about 8 o'clock or so that night, I was totally exhausted. I'd been up way over 24 hours, and I was done, and I knew I had a long drive ahead of me, so I finally got myself to bed, and a matter of 2 hours or so later, I was up, so I hadn't had much rest at all. So I got everything together, got in the car, and I left the house. It was about 11 o'clock that evening, so on a matter of 2 hours of rest, I was on the road. Now, I had a three and a half hour drive ahead of me because I had to go up to Dover Air Force Base. So anyway, I'm headed on this trip. I'm all excited about where I'm going. I think at the time I was going to Hawaii. It was either Hawaii or Japan. So I was on my way up, and I was just driving, had my cruise set on 55, 60, whatever the case may be, and I was just, you know, just relaxing as typical. And I was about 45 minutes away from the base, so I was getting close, and next thing I knew, I was asleep. I was totally asleep at the wheel. Cruise lock, going straight down the highway, asleep. And I know I was asleep. It was a good sleep. But all of a sudden, I heard this audible voice in my head. I heard it. It said, "Wake up." And I guess in my mind, I questioned it, and I heard the voice again said, "Wake up." And that time, I opened my eyes. And when I opened my eyes, I was going through. I was just feet away from going into an intersection. I had a red light. And as I opened my eyes, in the intersection was a tractor trailer going through the intersection. And at the same time, my foot hit the brake and just locked the brakes up. And I slid into the intersection, and I missed hitting the rear end of the trailer of the truck about. I missed it by no more than 2 or 3 inches. And, you know, naturally, I was just like in awe. But the first thing I did do, I said, "Thank you, Father," because I knew, at that moment, I knew that the voice I heard was from the Holy Spirit. That's the only way you can ever explain something like this. Whenever you hear that audible voice in your head to tell you to do something or not to do something, it's the Holy Spirit trying to communicate. And it's important that we listen to that voice because it's real. Remember, spiritually, communication is through the mind. It doesn't have to be a face-to-face audible voice like I'm doing right now. It's through the mind. The Father can speak to us in our minds, and it's a real voice that we can hear. And at the time, I was just so thankful and was so, you know, much full of praise for him for sparing my life. And he had a reason, you know. And it had just so happened during that time, I had just started getting into the message and scripture itself. So, you know, I'm thankful that he spared me at the time so I could learn the things I know now. And needless to say, I continued on with my trip fully wide awake due to the shock I was in. And everything worked out well. But to this day, I never stopped thanking him for that. And it just so happened a few days ago, a similar situation arose. But I'll tell you about that one later. I don't want to, you know, bore you with too many testimonies in a row. But my point being is, listen to when the Spirit is talking to us, because it can be detrimental to your health, someone else's. It can mean so many different things, but it's important that we pay attention. So, with that being said, once again, thank you, Father, for sparing me, and thank you for another day. This is Tube 87. I'm out.